Welcome to the Bible study. If this is your first time, please know that the full transcript is down below. Also, hit the like and subscribe. That helps get it out to other people. Also, look for a link to the new website. Get to know the commentators and the voices of this Bible study and links to other resources. With all that said, let's get into the study. The Taunt of Greed from Habakkuk 2, 6 through 8. Will not all of them taunt him with ridicule and scorn, saying, "Woe to him who piles up stolen goods and makes himself wealthy by extortion. How long must this go on? Will not your creditors suddenly arise? Will they not wake up and make you tremble? Then you will become their prey, because you have plundered many nations. The peoples who are left will plunder you, for you have shed human blood. You have destroyed lands and cities and everyone in them." Some context. For the rest of chapter 2, we find five taunt songs, often called woes, against evil of the Babylonians. The Nelson's Bible Dictionary describes a taunt song as a song of contempt or mockery. Job said of his enemies, "And now I am their taunt song," from Job 30, verse 9. Although it seems odd in our modern Western culture, but taunt songs were a very common type of literature in the ancient times. The Hebrew word for taunt, masal, has a broader meaning than our current use of the word. The same word is used for proverb in the books of Proverbs and is translated as parable in Greek. It is not only a ridicule, but a warning which contains truth. In this case, it is a prophecy in the form of a taunt song sung by the Lord Almighty himself. However, before we read these taunts with our accusing finger pointed solely at Babylon, we find similar woes given to Judea for their sins. The same sins that Habakkuk was lamenting about in chapter 1, although a much smaller scale, see Isaiah 5, 8 through 30 and Amos 2. Other taunt song examples can be found in Psalms 115, 4 through 8, Ezekiel 28, and Isaiah's taunt against the Babylonians in Isaiah 14, 3 through 23. The taunt. Woe to him who piles up stolen goods and makes himself wealthy by extortion. Recall in our last Bible study, the verse we are told that the Babylonians' greed is as wide as Sheol, like death he has never enough. The term extortion in this verse means to take a pledge and steal it by force. They were enriching themselves at the expense of others by the conquest of their home countries, making vassals of the nations and extorting from them huge contributions of materials, money, men, bleeding them dry. The result. Will not your creditors suddenly arise? Will they not wake up and make you tremble? Then you will become their prey. The Lord uses the analogy of a lender and a debtor who piles up debts and pledges far beyond their means. In their extortion of nations, they have built up a burden of debt by wrongfully acquiring the wealth of other peoples. But eventually, the lenders come calling, demanding their money, leading to total ruin. The consequences. The peoples who are left will plunder you. This taunt will come from survivors of all the cultures that have been destroyed. The Babylonians will tremble as the nations wake up and come to collect their debts. They will plunder the plunderer. This cycle of violence and plunder is the way of power in the ancient world. The taunt given by Yahweh teaches us of the foolishness of the way of power. Unjust power that is used to create wealth will be used to undo that wealth. The rise and fall of Babylon is like a living parable or a living proverb to teach about greed and power. Application. James Montgomery Boyce tells us, "Greed is a natural but destructive characteristic of the one who will not trust God. If a person trusts God, he does not need to be covetous of more and more material possessions. The Lord is the portion of the righteous. For many people, Amazon has become a new place of worship for much of the modern world. One can get almost anything you want just by pushing a few buttons on your phone. Many people we know have driven themselves into deep debt just because they needed to have the latest edition, the most popular, or something bigger and better than their friends. For many, more is better. Many years ago, the commentator who wrote this was crushed by debt, but through discipline and God's grace, they got themselves out of debt entirely. Jesus tells us, "Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." From Matthew 6:19-20. Today's application is to take a good look at your treasures on earth and compare them to your account in heaven. If you're like us, it looks like we still have a lot more to do to balance our accounts. That's our Bible study and commentary for this session. We thank you for sticking it out this far, and we pray that God will bless you for seeking His Word and the understanding of His Word. And certainly we ask you to hit the like and subscribe button. And again, the full transcript is down below. And check out the new website. The description for that is down below also. And we will see you in the next one. Thank you.